You are listening to KLRN Radio, where liberty and reason still reign.
All writers are prone to becoming so attached to our characters and stories that we struggle to see why a passage may not be working. It takes another set of eyes to help us nurture our writing to full maturity. At Black Wolf Editorial Services, we strive to enable writers to develop and grow, shaping stories into masterpieces that can stand the test of time. Editing services are provided for all genres and all age categories. Services range from critiques of the short story through to the line edits of the full-length novel and copy editing for those preparing for publication. We also offer assistance on generating a writer's bio for your websites, as well as help with those book blurbs and promotional material. We won't abandon you to the masses. We want to celebrate with you and your successes. Black Wolf Editorial Services, nurturing your writing into maturity. For a full list of services and prices, visit us at blackwolfeditorial.com.
Individuals and businesses with tax problems, listen carefully. Do you feel like you're losing control over your finances? If you owe over $10,000 in back taxes or have unfiled tax returns, we can help you take back control. The IRS is the largest and most aggressive collection agency in the world, and they can seize your bank account, garnish your paycheck, close your business, and file criminal charges. Take control of your tax problems now by calling the experts at Tax Mediation Services and take advantage of the Fresh Start program and new laws that may allow us to negotiate a settlement for the lowest amount possible. Our team of tax attorneys and enrolled agents can stop collections and get you protected so you can take control of your financial future. Tax Mediation Services is accredited by the Better Business Bureau. Call now for a free case review and a price protection guaranteed quote.
Call Tax Mediation Services now at 800-610-9050. That's 800-610-9050. 800-610-9050.
KLRN Radio has advertising rates available. We have rates to fit almost any budget. Contact us at advertising@klrnradio.com.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it, there to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
ladies and gentlemen. He's a child of God, a husband, NRA conservative, radical right-wing supervillain, and Twitter rock star. American by birth, Texan by choice, and a badass by nature. He's the owner of TomOHalloran.com, OHalloranMedia.com, and PatriotRadio.net. Please welcome Tom O'Halloran.
And welcome back, America. Welcome to the Patriot Radio Show on this fine Monday morning. I'm your host, Tom O'Halloran, and I'm broadcasting today from my underground bunker deep in Arcantana, Brascarado. I'm here to educate, irritate, and agitate. And folks, I guarantee you 110% agitation by the time this show's over, or my dear friend Catherine will give you triple your money back at the door. Again, my name's Tom O'Halloran, my primary blog, TomOHalloran.com. You can find us on Facebook at Facebook.com/Patriot Radio Show. Personally, you can find me at Facebook.com/O'Halloran. Mic adjustment here. There we go. And we do this show 5 days a week, most weeks. Please tune in at 9 a.m. Texas time, Monday through Thursday, for this, the Patriot Radio Show. On Fridays, we do Jihad on America. There we cover the Islamists in America, sharing with you who they are, what they want, and why you should be afraid. If you did not catch my show on the Muslim Brotherhood, my show Islam is Not a Religion, or my show on Islamophobia, then please find your way to PatriotRadioShow.com. Listen to all three of these shows. They will give you insight and perspective that you've probably not heard elsewhere. They'll also give you a solid foundation upon which we build each and every Friday as we continue to pull back the mask of Islam, looking at what's being done in the name of Allah, both here and abroad. And we do the news about Islam around the world, because it's a glimpse into the future of what's in store for us here in the homeland if we continue to allow the cancer of Islam to spread. Keep abreast of my shows, listen to the live stream, as well as catch up on the archives of any shows you may have missed, all at PatriotRadioShow.com. This show is rebroadcast daily at ConfederateBroadcasting.com, at ConservativeRadioNetwork.com, at LibertyWorks Radio Network, and at RedNationRising.us. You can also take the show on the road with you with your iPhone or Android. Just download the TuneIn app and then do a search for the Patriot Radio Show. I hope everybody had a great and blessed Thanksgiving weekend. Many of you had family over. Family time can be a good thing if you've got the right families. I posted on Facebook, somebody was wishing me a happy time with my family. I said, tell me which one you want. It's either or, okay? I'm either going to have a happy weekend or I'm going to be spending it with my family. It's not always the same, but for those of you that have families that you enjoy, I hope you spend it with them and had fun. I did have a good friend of mine and his wife over, and their little one, and we had a blast. A lot of food. Everybody filled up, took food back home with them so I wouldn't have to face the food anymore. Anyway, it was a great time. I had pledged last week to do a show on Thanksgiving and a show on Friday. But sometimes I make my plans, and my wife makes her plans. And it turns out she had planned to have my butt in a church pew Thanksgiving morning. So I did not show up here, and then we had something else that she had scheduled unbeknownst to me for Friday morning as well. So my apologies for those of you that had tuned in and expected a show, but that's what happened. And tomorrow I've got an appointment over at Social Security because, yes, I'm eligible. And I'll be heading over there bright and early in the morning, so I'll miss my show tomorrow. And because of that, I'm going to do a little juggling on my schedule this week with my co-host. I've asked Bill Perriman to join me today. Bill, are you there, brother?
Roger that, Tom.
Good.
Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. Hope everybody had a good one.
Amen. And I don't know whether you had turkey or turducken or what you had, but I hope everybody ate plenty and just had a real good time relaxing, watching some football and stuff. Good to see
you. Oh, I did watch some football now. I watched them Cowboys. First time I've seen them in about 5 years.
Oh, really? I heard.
Yeah.
I heard the Texans took a dive yesterday, though.
I don't know about them, but yeah. The Cowboy game was rather interesting. Them three guys. I was with Larry, a good friend of mine, and his 30 family strong. And they're all great big Cowboys fans, but all I heard all day was Zach, Zeke, and whatever the third one is, I don't know. But they got the three names that they were just throwing them out there. These guys evidently are phenomenal. That's the first time Cowboys have ever gone 10 wins and no losses.
Wow. That's huge.
In their history.
Yeah, that's huge. That's huge for anybody to do that. But Cowboys, it's good to see them back again. I used to watch football way back in the day when they were a real
Tom Landry.
What's that?
Tom Landry. I used to watch him.
Yeah. I watched football back in the days of Tom Landry and Air Coryell out of San Diego. There were three teams that were just monsters. It was Air Coryell's Chargers, it was Tom Landry, and it was the Steelers. Those three teams were just powerhouses. And somewhere along the line, over $1 billion paychecks and all that, I just kind of lost interest in football. I haven't followed it at all. And I'm kind of interested, since I'm here in Texas, and they've got a lot of loyal Texas, you know, fans and stuff, and I hate walking into a bar and somebody saying, hey, did you see the so-and-so team? I'm like, yeah, I'm not really a fan. I feel like a traitor. But anyway, let's get into the show here. And again, shout out to everybody in the chat room. Richard, it was great having you and your wife over, and my little friend Charlie as well. Carol, I know you were in here looking for a show on, Thursday or Friday? I remember seeing your name in the chat room looking around saying, where's that deadbeat radio host guy? KC. I know you took a week and a half or 3 weeks off, but you do that every week, so what am I going to say? We're going to start the show today, brother, with a little bit of our good guy with the gun segment. We haven't done it for a week or two, so I'm going to do three separate stories. We're going to start out in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Tulsa woman shoots a man after he breaks into her apartment. The Tulsa police said a woman shot a man when he went inside her apartment on Saturday night. Detectives said the woman was on the phone with 911 when she shot the man after he broke into her apartment at Comanche Park Apartments near such-and-such street. He was taken to the hospital with serious injuries. The investigation is ongoing, and the police said no one was arrested. In Texas, Corpus Christi, man was shot in the torso after home invasion on Saturday morning. Corpus Christi police have reported. Around 3 a.m. Saturday, a homeowner heard a loud knock on the front door of her house. Homeowner said she looked out the window, did not recognize the stranger at the door. She went to tell her husband about it, and the couple heard the man come in through the back door. I think I did this story last week. The husband shot the man in the torso. Trespasser was taken to the hospital. Condition and age of the trespasser were not available. Blah, 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 blah. And finally, we're going to talk about Midland, Texas, where my dear, dear friend KC is known to be a good shot. Out of Midland, Texas, Officer John Kerrigan teaches self-defense class for the Midland, Texas Police Department and said there were three things he tells his students whenever a situation arises, because the main point is staying alive. There's so many people playing video games and you kill somebody and it's no big deal. You just reset. Well, in real life, you don't get a reset button. This wasn't a game. As the victims of the attempted robbery explained to New West 9 the day after the nightmare scenario he faced, the victim said he was forced into a vehicle after having an AK-47 pointed at him. But the legal owner of the handgun himself said he caught the distracted suspects off guard when he pulled his own gun out for protection. Officer Kerrigan of Midland Police said, if you got to resort to those lengths to protect yourself, then you have to do what is necessary. And that is what you, if that's what you need to do, then do it. Kerrigan added, he tells the students he teaches during his self-defense classes three tips. Give away the material items that the person wants, because those can be replaced. Be good witnesses, because your description of the suspects matter. And to make sure the first call you make is to the police and not the family or friends. One of those other things is for people to carry themselves with confidence. You don't look like a victim, but don't go overboard in your defense as well. Kerrigan said watching through your surroundings is essential as well. The victim told Nine West News after he pulled out a gun on the driver that the driver crashed into a dumpster in the concrete barrier. He then pointed the gun at the driver and demanded his wallet and left the car. So, you're being robbed, you're forced into a car, you pull out your gun, cause them to drive into a dumpster, then you take their wallet. Victim and the police arrived in a matter of minutes, and the police are following leads into who the suspects are. So, good guy with the gun saved three different families this time. So, three families will be having a good Christmas that could have been otherwise turned. So what about yourself, brother? Did you have a good Thanksgiving weekend?
Oh, I actually did. We went to Larry's daughter's house. She has a huge place right over on North Fort Worth, a new area that they're building up. And her friend there has a huge drum set. And Larry and I got to sit down and jam for all the kids and play them music they've never heard.
All right. Larry's your buddy from the band?
Yeah. We grew up together, and he's always played. I love music, and I love playing with him, but I was a car idiot and motorcycle enthusiast at the time, and my life went another way than his, and...
Well, I appreciate you sharing that with us, because I've always wondered what kind of an idiot you were.
Yeah, well, there you go.
A car idiot. Okay, well, folks, now we know. Well,
oh,
good.
I regret it.
Good.
I do.
And sometimes spending the weekends, the holidays with family doesn't mean doing it with blood either. So that's a good thing. Glad you had a place to go up there where you were. Made it.
Oh, yeah. Well, in a way, he is blood, because, you know, I'm the only one left, so he is my family.
Right? Well, good. I'm glad, brother. Real happy for you. Now, before we get into the political stuff, well, this is political as well, but this is a little more an offshoot thereof. Obama handed out 21 Medals of Freedom. That's the highest civilian honor one can receive. 21 civilian Presidential Medal of Freedom. So what do you have to do? Do you have to rush into a burning building? No. Do you have to rescue people that are being held captive? No. Well, let's take a look at some of these people that have won this Medal of Freedom from Obama. There's Ellen DeGeneres, who donated $35,000 to Obama and $100,000 to Hillary. There's Robert De Niro, who donated $10,000 to Obama Victory Fund and $2,500 to his general election campaign. Tom Hanks donated $2,300 to the election campaign in 2008, $2,500 in 2012 and 2,700 to Hillary's primary campaign this year. Michael Jordan threw a $3 million fundraiser for a $20,000 plate dinner for Obama. Lauren Michaels from Saturday Night Live donated $4,600 to the Obama Victory Fund. Bruce Springsteen donated $13,000. Robert Redford endorsed Obama in 2012 and fundraised for Feingold in 2016. Bill Gates donated $17,000 to the Obama Victory Fund and $50,000 to inauguration. Melinda Gates donated $35,000. You see what this freedom is about. You're free to give me money, and I'll give you pretty medals to put in your showcase.
Yeah, exactly. And this happened during the Thanksgiving holidays.
Right.
Now, know this. A real American, Lieutenant Dan, Gary Sinise,
absolutely,
took his money, and he went to Afghanistan, and he fed our troops turkey dinner for Thanksgiving.
Absolutely. And this wasn't a photo shoot. This wasn't, I'll get up there and I'll serve turkey for 5 minutes while you get an angle. Let me make sure you get the camera over on the left side because that's my... No. Gary Sinise, American actor. He's the actor that played Lieutenant Dan in Forrest Gump. He's got a band called the Lieutenant Dan Band. But he also goes out and himself builds home. Doesn't just donate money. He goes out and he drives the hammer. Builds home for disabled veterans. He spent his money, flew over to Afghanistan, and personally served up the entire time they were eating, served meals to our soldiers. And I don't think there is video of it. If there is, it's a snippet. But, I mean, he doesn't do this for the cameras. This man is a soldier's hero.
I've seen one still picture.
Yeah. It isn't a publicity stunt with Gary Sinise. He's an honest-to-God hero, and he's got a foundation where he raises money to help build these homes and do these things for these veterans. So
I mean, a great American,
yeah.
And he wasn't even mentioned by Obama.
If you are, oh no, Obama was too busy praising Fidel Castro.
Yeah, buddy.
Okay, and here's another thing. Okay, the media for the last 6 months has been talking about how horrible it would be to elect Donald Trump to be president. Oh, he'll end up being a dictator. It'll be horrible. He's going to be a dictator. Oh, dictators are horrible. He's going to be evil. He's going to be a dictator. Well, they've taken a couple of days silence about ranting about how evil dictators are because they've been praising Fidel Castro, who has bled the people of Cuba. He's been a horrible, horrible man. And Obama, Justin Trudeau, the Prime Minister of Canada, the 49ers quarterback, asshead Kumperdink or whatever his name is, have all praised him for being a true leader. No, he's not a leader. He's a ruler, a dictator. Okay, he imprisons people who speak out against the government, which is why Obama praises him, because, wow, you've got the courage to do that. I can't imprison Tom O'Halloran. So, yeah, if you're looking for some place to donate money to, I know a lot of us are having trouble doing that these days, but if you're looking for a place to donate money to, look for the Gary Sinise Foundation. It could be the Lieutenant Dan Foundation or the Gary Sinise Foundation. But I can guarantee you every dollar that's donated to that goes to the veterans themselves, not to a president of the organization, not to the chief fundraisers, not to volunteers that man the phone banks. Volunteers man phone banks.
And here's a thought I had right after I saw him doing this and heard about this. I thought, you know, what better person to lead our Veterans Administration?
Oh, absolutely. Somebody mentioned that last week on the show. That may have been you. But absolutely. And you know my plan for the VA. Replace everybody in the VA with a veteran. If you're not a veteran, be prepared to leave the administration, because that's just what really needs to be done to turn it into a true, true Veterans Administration. Brother, we're going to take a quick break here. We're going to come right back, and we're going to get into the nitty-gritty of politics. We're going to talk about some of the people in line for cabinet positions and such. And we'll pick it up right here when we get back, all right? Folks, this
sounds
is,
good.
This is the Patriot Radio Show on a Monday morning. Please stick around. We're going to be right back. We has more.
Friends, it's certainly true that when you smoke, you want smoothness, mildness, and deep down enjoyment. And that's precisely what you'll get with every Lucky Strike you light, because there's never a rough puff in a Lucky. Just think of that, friends. Luckies are always smooth, mild, and mellow every puff of the way. For you see, it takes fine tobacco to make a fine cigarette. And LSMFT, Lucky Strike, means fine tobacco. Now, fine tobacco costs more, and Luckies pay more. That's right, Luckies pay millions of dollars more than official parity prices to get ripe, mellow tobacco for your Lucky Strike. Just listen for a moment to what the tobacco experts say about the kind of leaf Lucky Strike buys. Take Mr. L. Garland Griffin, a tobacco auctioneer from Clarksville, Virginia, who recently said, "All in all, I've sold over 100 million pounds of tobacco. And season after season, I've seen Lucky Strike buy fine tobacco. Prime, ripe leaf. The kind of tobacco for downright good smoking. I've smoked Lucky's regularly for 14 years. Now there's a tip for you, friends, from a man who really knows tobacco. So for your own deep-down smoking enjoyment, light up a Lucky. You'll agree with the tobacco experts, with the millions who choose Lucky's for a finer, milder, smoother smoke. Yes, puff after puff, pack after pack. There's never a rough puff in a Lucky. Good reason to make your next carton Lucky. Friends, it's certainly true that when you smoke, you want smoothness, mildness, and deep-down enjoyment. And that's precisely what you'll get with every Lucky Strike you light, because there's never a rough puff in a Lucky. Just think of that, friends. Luckies are always smooth, mild, and mellow every puff of the way. For you see, it takes fine tobacco to make a fine cigarette, and LSMFT, Lucky Strike, means fine tobacco. Now, fine tobacco costs more, and Luckies pay more. That's right, Luckies pay millions of dollars more than official parity prices to get ripe, mellow tobacco for your Lucky Strike. Just listen for a moment to what the tobacco experts say about the kind of leaf Lucky Strike buys. Take Mr. L. Garland Griffin, a tobacco auctioneer from Clarksville, Virginia, who recently said, "All in all, I've sold over 100 million pounds of tobacco. And season after season, I've seen Lucky Strike buy fine tobacco. Prime, ripe leaf. The kind of tobacco for downright good smoking. I've smoked Lucky's regularly for 14 years. Now there's a tip for you, friends, from a man who really knows tobacco. So for your own deep-down smoking enjoyment, light up a Lucky. You'll agree with the tobacco experts, with the millions who choose Lucky's for a finer, milder, smoother smoke. Yes, puff after puff, pack after pack. There's never a rough puff in a Lucky. Good reason to make your next carton Lucky.
Hello, everybody, hello. Hello is the shampoo that glorifies your hair. So hello, everybody, hello. With softer, lively curls and brighter, sparkling hair. So hello, everybody, hello. Hello, shampoo, hello. Hello, everybody, hello. Hello is the shampoo that glorifies your hair. So hello, everybody, hello. With softer, lively curls and brighter, sparkling hair. So hello, everybody, hello. Hello, shampoo, hello.
Cuckoo.
Tom O'Halloran, holding the line against tyranny from Washington, D.C.
We are back. It's the Patriot Radio Show on a Monday morning. We're on the phone with my good buddy Bill Perryman. Bill's reporting an active shooter situation on Ohio State University campus. Bill, did you get any details out of that yet?
I just posted the link. I have not had a chance to open it yet and look at it. I am doing so now.
This is active as we're speaking, so...
Yes, it just broke. They're telling everybody to run, hide, fight.
There you go.
Watts Hall.
Watts Hall? Okay. If you listen to this and you're in Ohio State University, avoid Watts Hall. It sounds like it's the site of the active shooter. Run, hide, fight. I would not necessarily that order. I'd run to the fight. But then again, I'm a good shot, so... okay, we talked last week about potential candidates for, you know, feel free to break in, you guys, if you come up with any new stuff on this Ohio State thing. But we talked last week about potential nominees for Donald Trump's candidacy or for his cabinet. And there was talk that not Ann Coulter, the other one, Laura Ingraham was slated to be the...
Press secretary.
Now it's looking like Monica Crowley may be the sleeper appointee on this.
And, either
one would be good. I think Monica Crowley is probably going to have the edge because, I just said her name and I'm drawing a blank on her name already. I do like the other one. What, I just said her name. How can I not have it?
I can't believe this. My brain is locked. Laura Ingraham.
I like her. I love her. I mean, she's mouthy. She's mouthy and a little more agitating, if you will, than Monica Crowley. Monica Crowley speaks her mind, but she's not as. Not as in your face, and I think she's just a little more polished. And I think KT McFarland, she's been mentioned as well. Yeah, KT McFarland would be good. She's been inside the White House, of course. So has, so have both of these others. Laura Ingraham and Monica Crowley both worked for Richard Nixon, although I think Monica Crowley did it after he left the White House. But KT McFarland would be as good as well. But I think KT McFarland probably has some experience as a political advisor as well. So we'll see where that goes. I believe she's been like Assistant Secretary of State or some office in there. I want to talk.
I still like my choice of that other gal, Milo Yiannopoulos.
That's not a gal. Milo would be funny. Milo is a flamboyant, let me say it my way first, flamboyantly gay young man. Although what he says he is a flaming faggot. And he just pisses off the left. You would think the left would love him because he's gay, but he's very, very conservative. So they just, blood comes out of their eyes when he gets up and talks. When you see a gay man standing up there and stage prancing around in a pink tutu, talking about conservative things like getting a job, you dumb idiots and stuff. We've got a major recount underway, folks. If you haven't been paying attention, Jill Stein stepped up this last week and said that she's going to try to appeal for a recount a recount of the ballots in Michigan, Pennsylvania, and Wisconsin. Now, Obama won all of these states. But here's the thing. Why would she do this? She has no chance in hell of gaining anything from doing a recount. She didn't get 1% of the total ballot. She doesn't really have a stake in the race. But she's raising money, and she has raised $7,000 or $8,000 now for this recount.
Well, she has two big problems. One problem is Wisconsin is paper ballots. The second problem is a judge has already told them that unless they prove or have proof of vote tampering, he will not allow the recount to happen.
Right, and I believe that was Wisconsin or that was that Pennsylvania?
That was Pennsylvania.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's Pennsylvania. Wisconsin is a paper ballot. But here's the thing, and she really needs all three of these. Well, let's get one thing on the table first. This is not about Jill Stein. This is about Hillary Clinton. She's probably going to backdoor Jill Stein $10 million or $50 million, pay off her campaign debts or whatever it takes. This is about Hillary Clinton. She's been working behind the scenes since the election was called for Donald Trump. She has been fighting to get this overthrown this whole time.
I'm not sure how true this is, but I have heard at one point during the weekend that George Soros was pumping $160 million an hour into this.
Well, he's not. Maybe he is. Yeah, he's definitely behind it. But how much of that money is coming through him or his organizations, I don't know. But they are raising a great deal of money. Now, Jill Stein just let it leak on, I believe, on Twitter. She said, I can't guarantee that all of this money is going for the recount. Wait a minute. You've been asking for money for a recount. People give you money, and now you're saying you may go shopping at Saks Fifth Avenue?
Exactly.
What the hell is this?
And they're asking for their money back. Some liberals are
now asking for their money back. They're also finding out that Hillary's behind it and that George Soros is behind it. What did they think? Did they really think that Jill Stein wanted a recount? Because she thinks she got 1% of the vote? It was all about Hillary. And she's been pulling out all the stops. You can expect lawsuits. You can expect more challenges. And Donald Trump has to see this. And if he hasn't, he needs to, and I'm sure he has because I've backed him all the way. He knows what's going on. He's got people doing stuff. He's not telling us that he's doing it. But you can bet that Donald Trump is preparing to challenge three or four of Hillary's states as well. Here's what they're trying to do. If they challenge all three of these states, and if they can overturn all three of these states, which, mind you, is unlikely. It's very unlikely, okay? Because Donald Trump has won some of these states by 115,000 people. I'm going to try to dig up the actual numbers for each of these three states. I've got it printed out here somewhere. But he's won by a lot of votes. His lowest state out of these three, he won by a little over 10,000 votes. Some of the states he won by considerably more than that. But if they win, if this recount overturns all three states, then Donald Trump's electoral votes go from 306 down to 260 and denies him the candidacy. Okay, now they're just challenging three states, just enough to take him off the pedestal and make her the electoral vote winner. Now, it's a scary thing. Trump won by 70,000 votes in Pennsylvania, 27,000 votes in Wisconsin, and 10,000 votes in Michigan. But for the total of that, I think it's 46 electoral votes. And that's enough. If you take that off 306, it's enough to bring him down to 260 and give Hillary the electoral lead. That would make her the winner. Trump needs to not only fight the challenge and have people there to challenge every vote that they challenge, but he also needs to call in play some states that Hillary won in. Okay? He needs to flip a couple of states. If he can flip one state, well, he needs to flip. They're bringing him down to 306 if they get all three of these states. And they're not going to get all three states. I mean, Pennsylvania, 70,000 votes. What are the odds? Wisconsin, 27,000. But if they did, they bring him from 306 down to 260. What he needs to do is challenge a few states that would get him another 10 electoral
votes. Like California with all their illegals that voted.
California would be huge. But, I mean, the concept of challenging that would be just massive. But Hillary won in New Hampshire by less than 3,000. That would give him four of the electoral votes he needs, four of the 10. He won Maine by 20,000. She won Nevada by 27,000. So if he could just challenge these, if he got Pennsylvania, let's see, if Hillary were to steal Wisconsin, Michigan, and Pennsylvania, she'd be ahead on electoral votes at 278 to 260. So Trump would have to gain 9 electoral college votes from Clinton. Winning New Hampshire would give him 4, Nevada would give him 6. That would be enough to do it. Okay, and if he challenged in Minnesota as well, that would give him another, I believe that was 8. So he's got to get a couple of states in play to win back from her. So even if she managed to flip all three, he'd still be able to block the recount takeover. So it's a long shot for her to win it, but it's got to be done. And here's the one good thing, though. Pennsylvania is a big state. I don't remember how many electoral votes it has. I'm going to see if I can pull it up while I talk, which is not very likely. But if he can block Pennsylvania, because she has to show just cause, a highly likelihood of voter fraud, before they'll even entertain a recount. And without that, if that doesn't change the outcome of the election, then the whole effort is moot, and they might as well just fold it up. Okay.
Well, I think that's what happened in Pennsylvania. Is when that happened, immediately I started seeing the donations fall, and Jill Stein pulling back. Because they're going to have to prove voter fraud, and if they do prove it, it's going to be Democrat voter fraud.
Exactly. Okay, here's the thing. Pennsylvania has 20 electoral votes. If they can't present just cause to do a recount from the judge, which it would have to be a high amount of voter fraud, and most of the voter fraud in Pennsylvania is in Philadelphia, and that voter fraud is pro-Hillary fraud. So if they can't present a just cause to the judge to do this, because it's going to cost a lot of money, then they won't be able to change enough votes to make it worthwhile doing the recount. So the other two states don't make a difference. It doesn't matter. So hopefully the judge will be able to block any kind of, although the judges in Pennsylvania are probably going to be Democrats. So it may not be a very high threshold needed. So it's going to be a scary thing, but just in case, Trump's team has got to be doing this voter recount appeal thing for in some of Hillary's states as well. I think California would be the place to go because that would be 60 electoral votes, but the time it would take to recount California would take us well beyond January, where the president's got to be sworn in. I think that's probably why they need to avoid California. Even
Mexico might even be better, because I know there's tons of voter fraud there.
Yeah, even counting Michigan, I mean, it took them, because they had to certify Michigan 2 or 3 times. And the last time they certified it was just for a Supreme Court justice for Michigan, which that took like 15 days. So It's going to be a mess, but they're doing everything they can on their side of the aisle, and we've got to be doing the same thing on our side of the aisle. So let's pray that the Trump team is on top of that, and I'm sure they are. I'm sure they are. He's got the right people in play, and he's got the right advisors advising him to do everything that's got to be done. So I'm not going to do the Ken Crow thing saying it's all coming apart. He's not suing these states. He's not doing this. He's not. We don't know what he's doing. Trump doesn't show his hand. Trump is a gamesman. He's going to do what he needs to do, and he'll do it probably at the last minute so nobody knows what he's doing. So with that, my friends, with that, brother, we're going to take another break. And we will come back, and we'll finish up. Maybe we can find some updated news on this Ohio State active shooter thing while we're at the break. Folks, stick around. This is the Patriot Radio Show on a Monday morning. And Bill Perriman and I'll be right back. Please don't touch that dial.
Everybody's talking Temple, the new filter cigarette.
Far more charcoal, far more charcoal.
How does all that flavor get through all that charcoal in that new filter cigarette?
Temple, the secret's in the structure of Temple's all-new filter. Try the new filter cigarette, Temple.
Temple brings you far more activated charcoal than in previous filter designs. The first bonded charcoal filter. A new kind of filter for a taste too good to miss. Quite a strong filter, too. No health claim is made for Temple. Only the promise of easy draw, smoother taste.
How does all that flavor get through all that charcoal in that new filter cigarette,
Temple? The secret's in the structure of Temple's all-new filter. Try the new filter cigarette, Temple.
Waiter! Waiter! Bill, did you ever see such poor service? I'm going to call a manager.
Take it easy, Walt. What's mostly wrong is your grouch.
I'm sorry, Phil, but my digestion is so upset.
What you may need for your poor digestion is something that works after nature's own order. Try Carter's Little Liver Pills.
Good advice. When your digestion is upset and you feel headachy and irritable, take Carter's Little Liver Pills. You see, each day, nature normally produces about 2 pints of a vital digestive juice to help digest your food. If nature fails, your food may remain undigested, leaving you headachy and irritable. To feel cheerful and happy again, take Carter's Little Liver Pills. They increase the flow of this vital digestive juice quickly, often in as little as 30 minutes, and you're on the road to feeling better. Don't depend on artificial aids to counteract indigestion when Carter's Little Liver Pills aid digestion after nature's own order. Take Carter's Little Liver Pills as directed. Get them at any drugstore, only 25 cents.
Once upon a time there was an engineer.
Choo-choo Charlie was his name, we hear.
He had an engine and he sure had fun. He used good and plenty candy to make his train run.
Charlie says, love my good and plenty. Charlie says, really rings the bell. Charlie says, love my good and plenty. Don't know any other penny that I love so well.
Two beans times two beans is 4 beans.
Nescafe uses lots more beans.
10 beans times 4 beans, and add 3 more beans, make 43 rich coffee beans.
Yes, you get 43 beans in every cup of Nescafe, real coffee beans. That's all there is in Nescafe, 43 beans in every cup. Make Nescafe the all coffee instant coffee. With a let's have another cup, taste.
Extra beans means extra flavor. Today's Nescafe goes all the way for flavor with 43 choice beans in every cup.
You worked too hard, you ate too much, the cheesecake made you greedy. Let your aching head and stomach hear this message from Old Speedy. Alka-Seltzer, plop, plop, fizz, fizz. Oh, what a relief it is. Plop, flop, fizz, fizz. Oh, what a relief it is. Ah, those speedy Alka-Seltzer bubbles burst into action to relieve your upset stomach and aching head fast. Use only as directed. Oh, what a relief it is. What a relief.
Pepsi Cola hits the spot. 12 full ounces, that's a lot. Twice as much for a nickel, too. Pepsi Cola is the drink for you.
Tom O'Halloran, holding the line against tyranny from Washington, D.C.
I am America, one voice, united we stand. I am America, one hope to heal our land. There is still work that must be done. I will not rest until we won.
And we are back. It's the Patriot Radio Show on a Monday morning, post-Thanksgiving. And while I've got a stack of political stories and stuff to finish going through over the next segment, Bill's right. It spoke to me in the chat room. We need to come back to the story we talked about last week. Bill and I had planned on doing a Thanksgiving show just on it. But we can't let it slide. We have to mention it again, if nothing else, just to keep people talking about it. Pizzagate. Pizzagate. It's a pizza parlor in Washington, D.C. that is a pedophile and satanic hangout. The connections to Hillary Clinton and her campaign are deep and many. Now, I've put up some of the stories on a special blog. Did you see that over the weekend, Bill?
Yes, indeed. Yeah.
Okay.
I've been all over this stuff during the weekend, and it's just sickening.
Yeah, I made a special link. I'm going to pull it up here shortly. Give me just a minute. A very easy link to find so that people can remember it. So you can share this link outside of Facebook where it's easy to have links and stuff. I'm going to read the link off right here in about 1 minute.
We now have proof that the Podesta brothers were in Portugal the day of Madeleine McCain's disappearance. They were staying three quarters of a mile away at the known pedophile's home of Sigmund Freud's son.
Okay, now this is huge, my friends. Two things that he just said there. Madeleine McCann, you remember a story, a young girl, I think she was 8 years old, she went missing. It was all over the news and people trying to find her and all this. There were some suspects whose picture were taken off a nearby video cam or something else, and people said quite some time back, the guy kind of looked like John Podesta, or his brother Tony, or Mike, what I think his brother's name was Tony. But they said he kind of looked like that, but nobody ever did anything about it. Well, it turns out now that these two brothers were not only in Portugal at the same time, But they were staying nearby, like a mile away. And they were staying at the home of a pedophile. So the way the story is shaping up, Hillary Clinton's campaign manager actually picked up an 8-year-old girl and kidnapped her. Now, there were some other girls that were being held in a home being raped by adults. They escaped, and they were talking to the authorities. I believe this was in France. I'm not certain on that. They were talking to the authorities, and the authorities said, well, let me show you some pictures. And they showed pictures of missing kids, and they picked out Madeleine McCann out of the pictures. She said, that girl was there. These people killed her. And when it came around to showing pictures of known suspects, they showed the pictures of the Podesta brothers. And the kids gasped. And they said, those men are very, very, very bad. Yeah. So, the link, I want you to go check this out. Don't take my word for this. I've been researching and reading the same as Bill has. The links are all on an easy-to-find website. It's tiny.cc/pizza. There are three different collections of research there. There is an hour and 40-minute documentary that ties all of this stuff together. There are four buildings in a row, four businesses in a row. Two of them are pizza parlors. All four of these businesses are owned or run by the same people. And these people are closely connected to Hillary Clinton as well. These businesses...
And one of these owners, Tom, is a DOJ head who's supposed to be in taking care of the children.
Yes.
That's his job.
His job is to prosecute pedophiles.
Yes.
And he's involved...
And he is one of these people.
He's involved in a pizza parlor that uses pedophile symbols. And these are symbols that the FBI has identified as symbols that pedophiles use. This is how you spot pedophiles. These pizza parlors use pedophile symbols and satanic symbols. This is a ton of evil, my friends. It's horrible what's going on. And I beg you, please, go to tiny.cc/pizza, P-I-Z-Z-A, tiny.cc/pizza. There are three different collections of research to go through and hundreds of links to follow it through. You can start with the video. The video is an hour and a half tutorial. It takes you step by step through it, shows you who the players are. Why would a top Democratic, one of the top 20 most powerful people in D.C., why would they own a pizza parlor? Unless it's...
How does a pizza owner become one of the 50th most powerful men in Washington?
Right. Which came first, the pizza or the pervert? But this stuff is real. You've heard Obama talking about fake news sites. This is why. They don't want you believing anything that you don't hear about from NBC, CBS, and MSNBC, and ABC. But you know how corrupt these people are. They have basically been campaign spokespeople for the Obama administration. Why is Obama fighting so hard to keep Pizzagate silent? Please, do some research. Post these links. Go to my Facebook page. The easiest thing to do, go to facebook.com/O'Halloran. Find my meme. Retweet it. Email it to people. The links to all this stuff is in there. I don't care how you do it. This isn't about me getting my links around. This is about getting the word out that these people are doing this very, very evil stuff. And they're doing it right in public. Right in public.
One other thing about how arrogant Podesta is, this Google thing has a Google Homes. and they, some people let cameras into their homes to film everything in there. And this idiot proudly shows all this very sick artwork throughout his home, and that's on YouTube as well. You can literally take a virtual tour of his home and see this sick artwork. Now, they may call it art, I don't know, but it's...
Well, listen, you got to be listen. Sick to me. It is art. It is art as defined by the Constitution. People have a right to have whatever art they want. It is what's on the walls isn't child pornography in its own sense. Legally, child pornography are images of a child in a sexual position, somebody raping a child. That's right. What child pornography is. But John Podesta, Hillary's campaign manager, has pictures in his home, paintings and photographs of women, of children, half naked children in their little girl panties, bound up with their hands tied behind them, wearing nothing but the underwear, and sometimes bound up more than just their hands tied behind their back. Some of them are tied in bondage photographs with their arms and feet bound together. Okay, this is twisted. Is it legally art? Yeah, it could be hung in any art museum in the world. Does it show a sick, twisted, depraved mind? You're damned right it does. And these people need to be investigated, but they will not be investigated until enough of us start spreading the word. Pass the links to this stuff.
Yes.
Pass the links to this stuff around on Facebook, on your blogs, email it. Get it to people so they can find it. The link is tiny.cc/pizza. And I'm posting it to the top of my my Facebook page again with a plea for people to share this around. Brother, we're down to the final. What have you got on this? Keep it on this. Forget about the school district for this.
I'm just like you said, follow this up. It's getting out worldwide. It's getting more known. There are some arrests in some countries happening, but I'm not seeing any arrests here. And that's very disturbing that our criminal justice system is so corrupt and probably so much into this that they're not acting on it. And it's sad. Talk about a swamp that needs to be drained. We got one.
And if you do some research, Google the, now I'm going to forget the name of it. Google the Boys Town scandal. There was another pedophile scandal in Boys Town, Nebraska back in the 80s. And some of the kids escaped. A black Republican. Some of the kids escaped from this. They went to the authorities. The police called in the FBI. The FBI covered it up.
Yes, they did.
We did not have the internet. The FBI covered it up. They charged one of these children that talked about the adults raping her. They charged her with perjury. They sent her to prison, for 15 to 20 years. Now, that may have been overturned. I pray it was. But they charged her to protect the politicians that were involved in this scandal. Please, spread the word about this. Find out what it's about and spread the word about the Pizzagate scandal. Use the hashtag Pizzagate. Get it out there. This has to be told. It has to be shared. Use it on your blog. Use it on your Facebook. Use it on your Twitter. Pizzagate. Send people to the link. It's tiny.cc/pizza. Get the word out. Do it for the kids. With that, God bless you and yours, America. This is Tom O'Halloran and Bill Perriman. Bill, thanks for making me do this today. It's an ugly topic, and I kind of blacked it out and not been ready to go there, but thank you, brother.
All righty, good.
This has been the Patriot Radio Show. God bless you and yours, America. This is Tom O'Halloran. I'm Bill Perriman. We are so out of here.
ladies and gentlemen.